It's time for match number 10 of the Super Fives before we get into the Eliminator Zone. The Calicut Heroes have finished at number 1, so it doesn't really matter for them, except that they wouldn't want to lose momentum. Ahmedabad have to win in 3 or 4 sets, not 5 sets. Well, this is a match that shall decide who that third team shall be. Delhi will finish 2. Who is it going to be at number 3? Let's give you an update on what this match means for Ahmedabad. They are at 5. They can race up to number 3 if they win tonight. But take a look at the set difference. Minus 1 is what it is. And they've got to win in 3 or 4 sets. However, if they win in 5 sets, that's 3-2, it's the points difference that will come into play as well. So that's Bengaluru's only hope. David Lee watching very closely. Ahmedabad, meanwhile, in a must-win scenario, will be without the services of Nandagopal, Key Michael and Louis Lett alongside. How big a loss is that, Louis, for the defenders?
Yeah, it's huge. He scores double points or double figures in points most games. He's been fantastic, and we just hope that Nanda gets well soon. Like, we're all thinking of you because we know what an advert you are for the league and how hard you work behind the scenes. It's a big night now for Shaunty John. There's been a lot of talk about Shaunty John, how he was in season one. We've seen him come in with big moments, 5 and 6 points against the Kochi Blue Spikers. He scored 8-5 against Delhi. His passing's been there sometimes, it's not been there others, and we know with the defenders, their passing is the issue. They have a great offense, but this evening, Shaunty not only needs to score like Nanda, but he needs to pass incredibly well as well.
What I love about Shaunty John is his energy. I've seen a couple of times in the last couple matches, he's thrown his body on the floor to make a defense, and his team has let him down by hitting in the net or not getting it over. So I think just adding him on the court, he's raising the level of his whole team.
Now, Ahmedabad in this journey have discovered newer stars, even without Shaunty John, while Nandagopal was delivering. In the defense, though, they found a man that represents the peak of a mountain. The name is Shekhar Singh. A new star is born.
I love him. I think he's fantastic. You know, I'm always talking about the middles and how excited I get, but we saw how important in the last match. Aponza didn't show up. It was instrumental in the loss of Delhi. Here, this man's come to the forefront. 42 points so far, and 28 of them have been in the last 3 games. He's a tall, young, middle, a great find since Manoj has not been in great form this season. So I'm so impressed with what he's done so far, and I think if he has a big night tonight, good things for Ahmedabad.
And as a youngster, you want matches like these, right? Because you know what's at stake. If you win a big one for the team, it also raises your stock in the market.
Yeah, he's the fifth best blocker in this competition. He's probably played 50-60% of the game time because of Manoj, who's another brilliant blocker. He has nothing to fear, just like Jishnu. Go out and get it done, kid. Like, tonight's your night. It's the big occasion. And I think he'll play like he's got nothing to lose. He's pretty quick across the net. And also offensively, we talk a lot about his blocking, but offensively, he's pretty astute as well.
Yes, he likes those short sets that he's always happy to kill from the heart of that court. Now, their opposition, the Calicut Heroes, have for the first time in the history of this league made it through to the finals already, because no other team will go above them on that Super 5's points table. So, firstly, Calicut's psyche in this match. We will talk about the other aspects, but very quickly, what do you think Calicut's psyche should be? Should they learn a lesson from Delhi? Because momentum is such a key factor in this sport, in this league.
Yeah, certainly. They're going to come out. As we talked about, we don't know how they're going to come out. They're going to want to come out the way they're going to play in the finals. They lost the last match, or excuse me, they won the last match against Bengaluru. That was a big one for them. Jerome had a huge performance with 20 points. The next closest, I think, was Vikas with 7 and Daniel with 5. So he absolutely stood out there. There was one game changer by the name of Ashok, who cut those aces in the last minute. And I think if those kind of performances happen out again, it could be big.
Yeah, I tend to agree. Ashok was the game changer for multiple different reasons. The issue I've got tonight is that if Kishore and Shailin put out their first 6 and they don't perform because they're complacent.
I've just been told they are, so they're not taking any chances.
So first thing, I give you full credit. You're better men than I am to start with, because it's great for the league and it makes you get up that fair play table, let's put it that way. But the other side is, what if they don't perform well because they know that they're winning the league? What effect does that have going through to the finals? So that was my other question, is that you need to put players out there who have got a point to prove and feel like they need something to gain, because otherwise it could be a banana skin later down the track for them.
You know, Calicut is a team that takes great pride in winning on court. Now, very quickly, who would Calicut want Delhi to face in that eliminator? I'm not saying, you know, they'll want to win for sure, but would they rather have Delhi face?
Man, I think they're only going to want the strongest opponent against Delhi, because I don't think they're going to want to play against Delhi. So probably going to want Bengaluru.
Yeah, I agree with that. That was what I was going to try and say. I think the banana skin team are the Torpedoes because of the way they serve the ball and play defense. And I think they always play best when they are that bottom place team coming up. And I don't think anyone would want to play them in the Super Five. In the Eliminator.
It's Ahmedabad's game to win. They win by three, in three or in four, they go through to the Eliminator. Remember, they are defending champions. We'd forgotten that for a while because they were sort of on a downhill curve. But here's their chance, Ahmedabad. Angamuttu, Muthusami, Appavu, the key men. Key matchup for you guys heading into this blockbuster clash.
You already mentioned it there, Angamuttu. He had a massive matchup. He had a massive match, last time with 21 points. And we were kind of hot and cold on him. We weren't sure if he was having his best season. He proved that he is absolutely top of the table again, and he's going up against Jerome, who had 20 points in that Bengaluru match. So whichever one of those two players is firing, I think is going to have the advantage.
Yeah, it's a great matchup, and two of the best that India have got in that position. I'm going to go with Shanti John, because there's going to be a lot of pressure on Shanti coming in the point scoring role, and his matchup is against Chirag, who's been brilliant this year supporting Jerome Veneef on that right side. Tonight, Shanti has got to support Angamuttu to get the scoring done.
Prediction, that's the bottom line.
I don't know.
I don't either.
I don't
Nobody
know,
knows.
I don't know anybody
I wonder what David Lee is thinking. David, if
he
you're watching, a glass of chilled water will do you a lot of good. Don't you worry, your fate is not in your hands anymore. If Ahmedabad win in three or four, they go through, and we may see you next year. If not, well, you will be in action against the Delhi Toofans on Tuesday night. So,
do we have the heart rate monitor on Delhi as we speak?
I think we need the heart rate monitor on the three of us. And we'll start with 140. Full 100 marks for Indian Terrain for giving us these lovely shirts all through the tournament. Our wardrobe sponsors, they are our style partners. A very stylish blockbuster clash coming up. It's a box office encounter between the defending champions and the Calicut Heroes, who are already through to the finals. Ahmedabad win in 3 or 4. They go through. If not, it will be Bengaluru. Live action coming up on the other side.
The final match of the Super Fives, and there's so much riding on it here at the Rupe Prime Volleyball League. The Calicut Heroes, who have been superb all season, up against the reigning champions, the Ahmedabad Defenders, who need to win this 3-0 or 3-1 to secure their spot. The Bengaluru Torpedoes will be watching this with an eagle eye, as a win for Ahmedabad thoroughly threatens their place in the eliminator. Calicut have already taken top spot because of Delhi's poor performance against Mumbai moments ago. It's time to meet the teams downstairs with Atish.
Get ready for the last match of the Super 5 in the Rupe Prime Volleyball League, powered by A23. And it goes right down to the wire, doesn't it? Because the equation is simple for the defending champions. Win today and live to fight another day. Win today and get a chance to play in the final by the eliminator. Please welcome the Ahmedabad Defenders!
One of the league's most prestigious teams, runners-up in season one, winners in season two, led by Muthu Sammy into this arena, knowing that nothing but a win is acceptable this evening against old rivals at Calicut. In the Super Fives, it's been difficult for them. All matches are going to five sets. They would like to get this done quicker this evening to secure their place in the eliminator. They know, though, Calicut, although they are already champions of the Super Fives, will want to win.
They top the league stage. They are also on top in the Super Five. And one thing is certain, they are our first finalists. Please welcome the Calicut Heroes!
Here they come, backed by the Red Army and led by Captain Jet Jerome. The Calicut Heroes have cemented their place as first in the Super Fives. Well, they went 6-2 in the regular season. Two wins already here in the Super Fives, including a 3-2 over Bengaluru in the last match. Jerome had a huge performance in that one with 20 points. Ashok was the game changer with a couple of last minute aces sealing the deal. Well, there are a few other players to keep an eye on, including Daniel and Perotto, the foreigners, that could make or break a win here today. Let's see what happens.
Both teams are ready. Up machegi dhoom.
Well, it's the Daniel Motazedi derby as he goes back up against the team he won this championship with last year. But this year it's been about Jerome Veneath and his impressive form on the right side. The best scorer, 34 points, even better. And a big evening for that man there in your picture, Shanti John, riding the bench last year with injury, riding the bench for a lot of this season. Tonight will be his night to shine, and sport has a funny way of creating stories with the likes of Shanti John around. Calicut won the toss and they chose their side. Muthu Sammy, I think, has chosen to pass.
Well, here's a look at the Calicut lineup. Perotto of Brazil will be on the outside, Mann through the middle, and Daniel Motazedi will be joining him. Look out for both of them as part of this scoring machine that is the offense of Calicut. Chirag, well, he's been impressive all season long. He is the Robin to the Superman, who is Jerome Veneath. The Batman even is Ukra, potentially, with some sneaky little sets. But I like that they've gone with the same starting lineup that we're used to seeing. They are not taking this match lightly. These two head coaches, Shailin Ramdu and Kishore Kumar, who share jointly that head coaching position. It's the first time in volleyball history, or that at least I've ever seen, where there are two head coaches at the same time. Kishore Kumar, I believe, is wearing the heart rate monitor. A style icon with those green glasses. Let's see where it's starting at, 86. And I don't think this is gonna be a particularly stressful match for Calicut, considering they're already into the finals. Not only that, they are in the first position. So so they don't have to play that elimination match.
Reigning champs Ardaban Angamutu, keep an eye on him. 98 attack points with 47% efficiency. Shikhar gets the nod in the middle once more. He's been impressive, the fifth best blocker, having only played 50% of the game so far. Shanti John, that's the big news, in for the injured Nanda, and it means that there's a lot more pressure on Shanti's shoulders to bear the responsibility of Nanda's point scoring in this team. Max Seneca gets the nod on the outside. Ilya Barao from Belarus, the second middle blocker. Dragan Mihailovic over the moon with that comeback, the 3-2 win, even without Nanda a couple of nights ago. But the question will be, can they do it again? And it's this man here, Sajjad Hossein Malik, who's wearing the heart rate monitor. And my word, hold on, sir, we've not even started. And if it wasn't hot enough out there, it's getting hot in here, because Atish Tikral has joined us in the commentary box.
Wow, wow. Anti in seventh heaven because of that introduction. Thank you so much, Dinesh Das and Mullah Ilyas Shamim, officiating this game. And there is certain heat when you talk about the Ahmedabad defenders, because you know what the equation is. They need to win. And they need to win big. Even if they win 3-2, by the way, with a points differential of plus 5, then Bengaluru Torpedoes bow out. But at the other hand, the Calicut Heroes wouldn't want to give defenders yet another opportunity, because you know what the defenders are capable of on their own day.
There's so much on this match. It's going to be fascinating. So let's go, Ukra, with the first serve.
Yeah, and the angle man takes a swipe. Misses first point towards the Heroes.
Angamutu was one of my players to watch out for in this match. I'm not reinventing the wheel when I tell you he's a fantastic player, but 21 points he had against Delhi. So I have no surprise, or is no surprise there, that Mutu is trying to find him early. That ball just rolling out the end line.
There's more pressure on him this evening because there is no Nanda. So the lion's share of the point scoring has got to come from that right side, regardless, because Shanti's brilliant. Oh, and you ask whether Calicut will be there. They are certainly there. Indian Oil Super Serve from Ukra.
Ukra goes under the radar in terms of serving. Look at the ball in the air. Absolutely zero spin on it. That is as good as a float serve can get. Moves Max Seneca out of the way and tags that line. Beautifully done.
As innocuous as it could be. Tries it again, only this time it's a shy long. And Ahmedabad opened their account.
Another thing to keep an eye on, other than that tattoo from Kushar Kumar, very cool, is the connection between Max Seneca and Mutu, which was way off in the last match, and kind of flung the balance to being necessary for Angamutu to pick up that slack.
Is that a tattoo of himself?
Why not? Why not? You don't have a tattoo of yourself, Louis.
Meanwhile, a block that tattooed the ball onto the floor in the Heroes' corner means the defenders get 2 points back to back. Nanda's in the house, of course. We hope he recovers as soon as possible. An ACL injury means his tournament is curtailed now.
Huge loss for Ahmedabad. Huge loss for Indian volleyball. Fantastic player. We hope nothing but the best for him.
Meanwhile, it's Chirag Yadav, who wanted to add some spice with that spike. That's 3 points on the trot that the defenders have earned. And now it's parity.
Yeah, who knows what game we're going to get this evening. Because if I'm Calicut, it all depends on how much you dislike the defenders. If you really want to get one over the defenders, this is your chance. Kick them out of the competition. But if there isn't that rivalry between the two teams, it's going to be very difficult to keep that motivation.
Jerome Vinit, meanwhile, gets his first point, and I was a little wry with Jerome. When he was warming up, I went up and asked him, why are you playing today? And he just said, I have to play. I have to play. He seemed motivated.
There you go.
Perfect contactless shot. I don't think he doesn't he thinks about anything but volleyball. I think he eats, sleeps, breathes, dreams, attacks.
And also keep in mind that the Ahmedabad defenders have a record of defeating the Delhi Tufan, so there is a possibility that the Ahmedabad defenders may face the Calicut Heroes in the final, and that's a matchup that the Calicut Heroes may not want.
Yeah, that's what I said beforehand. It's all about the matchups. And I still think if Calicut were in the Eliminator, they would not want to play Bengaluru. But if it was the other way around, then Delhi now... Oh, sorry, if it was Delhi in the Eliminator like it is now, I think they'd be happy playing Bengaluru.
Calicut lost to Bengaluru in the group stage 3-2. And in the fives, they won 3-2. So they don't have a great record with Bengaluru.
Yeah, but that's one-off game, isn't it? As Calicut take a three-point lead. This is a swing that you're seeing. It's 3-0, then 3-all, and then 6-3, which prompts a timeout taken by Dragan Mihailovic.
Yeah, wild start to this game. And fair play to Calicut for coming out firing. Have a look at those guys, having the best time.
We should put a heart rate monitor on him today. Because today he'd be racing for a very different reason. Today he's just in the mood to dance. Safi PD, the co-owner of the Calicut Heroes, getting his family along to celebrate.
Speaking of family, there he is, D. Lee in the house with Lavi Lee. They are watching like hawks on this match, but he looks relaxed, doesn't he?
Yeah, I'm surprised his fingers aren't crossed.
They're enjoying the dance moves. I want to see them get... We've seen a couple of their dance moves as of late. I'd love to see them get involved in the crowd here. Lavi has some great dance moves, at least.
I thought you were about to talk about Sonny Joseph's dance moves.
I know nothing about his dance moves.
Meanwhile, Chirag fired in the serve. It was collected. A dig by Mukesh. Ukra Pandyan with the touch. Chirag has no other option but to palm his Srikant before Shikhar. Angamuthu jostles for the ball. Shanti John did enough, somehow. Moita said he finishes it. He's up against his former team, remember?
Yeah, this is the Motazedi derby. As he puts this one away. We were talking before this game, and I was making some pretty bold statements just to make a change. And I was just saying how Motazedi, for me, hasn't scored as many points as he did last year, but his efficiency is still higher than a Ponza's when it comes to point scoring. His connection with Ukra isn't as good as it was with Mutu Sami.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right there. They haven't needed to use that middle spot, but maybe it's needed to, or is it just that Ukra kind of uses him sparingly so that he can keep that efficiency so high? He's not trying to force him when he's off the net. He's not being really risky with that middle set. He's really only using it when he needs it.
Yeah, I agree. I think one of the downsides of Ukra setting side on is also that connection with the middle wouldn't be as strong as a setter who really gets around the ball and shows you where that ball's going.
And while this conversation took that turn, it was setting us down for the baseline. And guess what? He fires it out. It's the Amul Gul technical timeout, where the finalists for this season have a 4-point lead already.
It is a big matchup here, as is this A23 Top 5 Spikers matchup. Have a look at Jerome Benit. He's been at the top, I think, pretty much all season that I can remember. Santosh and the two Mumbai players, and there's Angamuthu right there at the bottom at number 5, creeping his way up after a fantastic performance 21 points in the last match. If he gets going, well, if either of these two get going, and this is what I called out in the pre-game show, whichever team has their opposite firing is the team that wins for me.
So the opposites will set it straight, is what you're saying. Shanti, John, got stuck in his fingers.
Shanti's been excellent in terms of adding momentum and generating points for his team. However, my one critique, he is a little bit shaky in certain areas. A couple of times, ball's gone through his hands. On reception as well, he's been targeted.
He's just caught in two minds there, though. He wanted to try and bump set that ball, and last moment he said, I'm going to set it. And for me, that shows lack of game time and lack of commitment to decisions in those situations.
Motosami, meanwhile, uses Angamuthu for the second time. He may have been blocked, but Motosami's like, Nana, we need Angamuthu yet again.
99 attack points for the angle man. And that's why they call him the angle man. Set him high, set him low, and he'll put the ball away.
He's great in out of system. I think he's one of the better opposites at just getting a high ball flung up in his direction and finding ways around the block.
Shikhar's an interesting character. Yesterday, right now, he's obviously made a service error, but there have been times when the defenders have managed high-scoring runs on Shikhar's serve somehow, even though it just seems like a floater that people should receive with ease.
Well, it's a good rotation, right? I think Mutu's backcourt, Angamutu's potentially front court, so he has a chance to get that big block in front of him.
Well, it's time for Jet Jerome to spread his wings and fly. And fly he did, out of the sky. You can't see the ball anywhere.
Yeah, have to put up a missing persons report for that one. As still travelling, and I've still got to say, you look at the two teams, the intention of Kanaka's been superb. I said in the pre-show that I would start my second team happily. But their first team have come out and got the job done to this point very well, very professional.
Clearly they don't want to. Clearly they want to ensure that the competition for them is as little as possible. Okra's been changed for Aman. Did Piroto touch the net? Not seen. Chelin Ramdu was trying to point it out. Chirag with the pipe attack thwarted. Also expertly by the Belarusian big man.
Yeah, so Aman's come in here. And that's the first sign that Kanaka are happy to rest their key players. And they're two sets that aren't in the right zone. That's a little bit low for me in that pipe attack. And also the back set was fumbled. So let's see if Aman can get to grips with this situation.
The response of Amdabad after that block for me tells me a lot. There was not a whole lot of celebration there. They don't seem to have belief, if you ask me.
Shanti John clips the block. Shanti John clips the hands off Mukesh. Amdabad defenders are creeping back in it. You can't see any Jerome Benin. You don't see Mohan Okra Pandian. And perhaps that's going to turn the tide.
Yeah, it will. It will, because this team rely heavily on Ukra and Jerome. Let's not beat around the bush. They're fabulous players, but the engine room of this team is the right side.
And you said something very interesting during the build-up. You said you've never seen, in the history of volleyball, you've never seen two head coaches together.
Yeah.
Well, history is meant to be broken, so why not here? Anyway, you've already invented new forms in the league, which are so exciting, like the SBI Super Point and the Indian Oil Super Serve. You now have the heart rate monitor to find out how nervous the coaches are at the sidelines. Oh, he's calmed down now. From 121, he's calmed down to 106.
That's surprising me, because by the look at his team, they're looking a little too chill, a little too on ice.
When Jerome comes back on, it'll go up again.
That's when he'll be nervous. 93 for Kishore Kumar. And interestingly, when I asked Shailen Ramdu about this two-coach dynamic, he said this is like the Swedish model in football. Meanwhile, there's an Indian Oil Super Serve by the angle man. And lo and behold, there's parity for the defenders. Angle man to the rescue.
As per usual, a beautiful Indian Oil Super Serve. And that takes Amdabad from 10-5 up to 10-10. This is how quickly things are changing in this league.
Mukesh, Vikas has to do the setting. Chirag sends it across. Muthusamy towards Sean T. John. That's poetry in motion. The defenders have the lead.
Well, I keep my eye on Jerome Nucre because they're coming right back in. Rupe contact is short. And this is the downside of chopping and changing, isn't it? They wanted to start with their main guys, then they wanted to rest them and protect them. And I don't think there's a halfway point here. I think you've either got to go for it or you've got to rest them.
Yeah, I agree. I completely agree. You can't be half-hearted about it. Just to keep their bodies warm and keep match practice on, nah, doesn't work that way. But what works is if you play an SBI Super Point at this juncture, which is what Shailin Ramdu and company have done. Big call, good call.
I like this call. I think this is an interesting juncture in the point, in the set, knowing that there's been a 6-point run by Ahmedabad. They have to stop it here, and they do. The SBI Super Point goes right back towards Calicut, gives them two in the right direction, and they reclaim the lead.
Yeah, well done to Ukra here. Just coming in, fizzing the middle. I thought it was a gutsy ploy to do it off the Angleman serve, and he's on such a glorious run, but I don't think they had any other choice but to call it now or never.
But then again, Louis, every time there's an SBI Super Point, you know that the server is going to put in a soft serve, they won't go hard. So even if the Angleman was on a good service run, you know he's going to be tentative there. Meanwhile, conservative strategy by Dragan, because they didn't call for an SBI Super Point. Had they done that, they would have been in the lead.
For the life of me, we saw this earlier with Shubham. Blockers pull their hands away for no obvious reason. And for me, I don't think there's any reason for them to pull their hands in this moment.
I tend to disagree. I don't think you needed to block there. Shanti showed his cards pretty early.
But the defense has to be alive.
He rolled it, he put his elbow down, he showed that he was going to target the block, but the defense got caught on the heels.
Which is why Mukesh has been replaced by Allen as the libero. Chirag, it ricochets off the net, ricochets off Seneca's hands. Calicut are creeping through.
Especially if you're a Torpedo right now and you're watching this game wondering what lies ahead for you in the next couple of days. Are you going to be playing for the medals or are you going to be going home? And to the outside, Chirag is just showing again what a great outside he is by slicing that ball sharp.
Vikas Mahan, Srikant, the mastermind towards the angle man. That's 100. He's attacked and he's attacked as the angle man.
100 attack points joins that century club here with this swing. The angle man doing exactly what the angle man does, finding the court.
Finding the corner.
Finding the point.
And the angle. Burao, finding Peroto, who found Okra, who found Mortazetti. Is the Prince of Persia that takes the heroes to set point. He doesn't seem nervous at all because right now Calicut heroes are on set point. That's why he's smiling.
Oh yeah, he is absolutely one-sided here. One fan of Calicut in the stadium. That's a beautiful swing by Daniel. A little hop step, a little jump step.
I can assure you, he's absolutely bricking it.
Meanwhile, Mortazetti also now has 50 attack points. Muthusamy, angle man to save the set. The angle man, for now, does save the set. Apologies in motion to Alan Ashik.
And of course, we do need a 2-point differential, but that's such a good swing. And there it is. There's the reaction from D. Lee. I think you're exactly right, Louis. He knows how quickly things shift between teams, and we've seen the best and the worst of all of these teams. It just is who shows up on the day. And it's heartbreaking for Bengaluru that their fate is in the hands of someone else.
He knows the camera's on him. He knows he's celebrating each point that the Calicut heroes are scoring. Chirag Yadav with the punt. Ah, the celebration. Let's go. Today, each Torpedo fan is a Heroes fan. Today, the head coach of the Torpedoes probably was giving tips to the Heroes.
That's
crashes it into Sean Dijon. Seneca, has he got the touch? Yes, he has. Yet another set point saved.
Gutsy swing from Seneca this. Ball was high and wide from Sean Dijon. Mutusami had to go for a safe and stable option. So he set that ball up, and Seneca's not used to ripping that one. And that was his only option, was to go high hands.
Who remembers when Calicut was up 10 to 5?
It seems like a long time ago.
What happened?
An Indian Oil super serve happened. But Chirag Yadav has other ideas. Through the pipe, yet another set point for the Heroes.
Let's see more pipe from the Heroes tonight. I think that's one of their strengths. That's the first that I can remember. But Chirag's so good at it, and Ukra finds him that hole every single time.
And set point number three for the Prince of Persia against his former team. Wow. He almost took a piece out of the Ahmedabad defender's dugout there.
He's looking confused, like he has some questions about if the ball might have been against him. I think they gave him a heavier ball, perhaps. Extra spin on it.
He's got back to his jump serve, which we haven't seen so much from Daniel.
Interesting observation, Louis. Shikhar, Ukra, Peroto, simple. Simple and beautiful. Set point number four.
Simple. There's nothing simple about that play. That is perfection in the pass. Heart rate of Kishore is, well, not rising that much, but that ball perfectly in and a double quick in front of Ukra. Gutsy, gutsy every single time.
If it's perfection, I'm sure he's practiced it. That's why it was simple. Meanwhile, Sean Dijon to Muthusami towards Sean Dijon. The Heroes have done it. There was a point when they were leading 10 to 5. The defenders mounted a comeback, but the Heroes remain unbowed. Eventually, they win the set.
Yeah, the pass got him in all sorts of trouble here. Chonti's passed really high two or three times. And as soon as that ball goes high, it puts the pressure on Mutusami. Gravity gets hold of the ball, makes it heavier. And because of that, the Calicut Heroes go up 1-0. We'll go for a very quick break. Well, there's a lot to talk about after the opening set that goes the way of the Super Fives champions, we'll call them for the time being, the Connecticut Heroes. They booked their place into the final already. 9 successful spikes though here against the 7 from the defenders. Strange set that one, Keen.
Yeah, coming back from 10-5, I believe it was. A big comeback by Omdivad, but they couldn't get over the edge there. You can head over to Volleyball World and get all the exclusive stats of this league, of the Super Fives, of the finals, with our international streaming partner, Volleyball World.
And if you are watching on Volleyball World and you're thinking, this is bonkers, it's because it is.
In the best possible way.
Oh, absolutely. It's the most fun that we've ever had watching volleyball, and every evening is a lot of fun.
Yep. Mixing a bit of Bollywood into the volleyball.
Ooh, yeah.
This is volleyball, ladies and gentlemen.
Volleyball, I like it.
Thank you. Meanwhile, hurrah with the ball. The start of the second set, and I just realized something. Should the end of our defenders lose today, we'd have 3 different champions in 3 different seasons as a certainty. Ashok Bishnoi, the game changer last time around against the Torpedoes. He's coming to the front court, and he's hammered in a spike.
How about that? Fresh faces coming to the party when needed. And it's a one-on-one, no surprise there. Mutu all by himself, all by his lonesome, because Ukra knew nobody was going to help him out there.
Yeah, well, this is interesting because they got a very strong side out there at the moment, but no Jerome Veneet is the big news for the second set.
I think this is interesting. Maybe for all you know, what Sherlyn Ramlo and Kishore Kumar are thinking, till Ukra's there, you can play Ashok Bishnoi, but if they play Aman, they'll get Jerome in, perhaps.
Maybe that's it. Change one piece of the puzzle, but not multiple pieces at one time.
So much drama because there's so much riding on this for so many different teams and players. But I think that with Ashok, Jerome obviously trusted him because he brought him on to serve against the Torpedoes. It wasn't a coaching decision.
It wasn't. It really wasn't. Jerome was the one on the sideline saying, come on in, come on in, I want you to come on in. And then eventually the coaches conceded and the battle was drawn.
Well, it's interesting because Jerome's only had 1 point in that last set. He wasn't as big of a factor as he typically is. So maybe, you know, just switching some things up, give him some time to watch from the outside.
I mean, let's be honest, Ashok doesn't look bad either, does he?
Absolutely not.
He's an absolute understudy for the Avengers, is Ashok.
The Avengers? Which team is the Calicut or the Avengers?
Daniel! No way!
Most definitely, he is a superhero for getting in the Indian Oil Super Serve.
Daniel the man. Wow. That is a huge moment for Calicut.
Indian Oil, the Prince of Persia. One of the biggest rigs in the league puts it away to the seam. It's a beautiful serve, and it's good to my eyes.
Oh, it does not get closer than that. Down to a hair, one of those fine hairs on his head.
Yeah, but there's nothing fine about the lead that the Calicut Heroes have right now. As the Ahmedabad defenders stare down the barrel of a 4-point deficit. Is your heartbeat racing, sir? Not so much. Not so much. He's on walking speed on the treadmill now.
That's where Louis is 95% of the time.
He's not even there. For Louis, it's all Spanish. For Louis, it's all about ambling. It's not even walking.
Lift heavy things, throw them on the floor.
That's exactly what the Calicut Heroes are thinking every time Ukra sets them. Lift heavy and then whack it on the floor. Moita Zeddy.
Oh.
Went for another big Indian Oil Super Serve, misses. And a wry smile by the Prince of Persia.
I would have loved to see that go in and have him get 2 back-to-back Indian Oil Super Serves. He hasn't been the toughest from the end line. However, again, the big teams turn it on when they need it. Find those little extra something in the pocket.
I don't know what the defenders need here to really kickstart their evening. Defense maybe for Mutu Sami's going to help. That's a little bit rushed. Very good defense, I think, Bukesh. But again, scrappy point one from the defenders. I think they have a chance, I really do. But I think they have to add a little bit of added energy into this.
Good effort there by Perotto. I like that one-handed set as well by Ukra. And the pancake. I mean, that's a pretty good display of volleyball. It doesn't come off the way Calicut would have liked, but even that little roll at the end, athletic.
You're in India, it's not a pancake, it's a dosa.
Maybe it's a crepe because it's an Olympic year for Paris.
It is. Alan Ashik, meanwhile, is the libero right now, not Mukesh. As a stroke, Bisnoi fires it back to Seneca, who's trying to settle himself after coming from the baseline.
An 8-2-3, super spike. We'll have a look at that whole rally again. Again, Ukra at the front, giving up absolute butter to his team right now.
Just set this kid all day.
Yeah, where's he been?
Set this kid all day.
Are you ready for some Bisnoi bazookas?
Oh,
he was celebrating, but then it's been given out eventually.
The only thing you can see here with Ashok now is he has a tendency to go away from the body towards that sideline. So for anyone watching later games, they'll start to prepare to shift across a little bit.
He completely flummoxed the Bengaluru Torpedoes when he came on, didn't he?
With that exact serve.
They were about to go for a review, but the time was up. You get 10 seconds to lodge a review. Perotto, Ukra with the dump. The mastermind reads it well. Seneca has the set for Shanti John, Chirag Yadav, Vikas Mann. Ashok tried to fly, but a shut her down time by Shanti John.
Yeah, that's the sort of play that we wouldn't see from Hetchinstall. He would hedge his bets against going after this, because that's so inside, he's always chasing it, and there would be something in his head that says, okay, I'm just going to volley this to position two or to position one.
And that's the kind of thing you'll get with experience the more you play. So Ashok, not having that much game time, doesn't know how easy it is for the blockers to come in on him there.
Right, keep in mind, they were 5-1 down. Now it's 6-5 in Calicut's favor, but the defenders have a chance to make it even Stevens. Perotto takes a swipe. Allen comes in. Ukra was set for Shafiq, but Burrow is there, and the big man ensures that the defenders aren't out of it.
Yeah, Ukra says my bad here. I think it's because he's tried to work something flash in the situation. In those situations, there's nowhere the middle hitter can go apart from hit six, because the ball's so far off the net, and that plays right into Burrell's hands. Literally.
Shikhar, Chirag, Ukra, Ashok Bisnoi. They have the lead, but it's not as ideal as it was a few points ago, because remember, it was 5-1 in the hero's favor.
You're exactly right. But I like that swing. I like this final swing, getting back to Ashok. He gets the width that he needs to show what he can do. I just wonder if he'll be able to last an entire match filling Jerome's shoes. Already got called out a little bit on that inside ball.
I'm already thinking that if he's in the auction next year, someone's got to make a move on him.
I wonder who you're talking for, or speaking for, Louis, as the angry man gets yet another point. Of course he's to the rescue. Of course.
Engelman, a little quiet so far in this match, considering how many points he put up last time around. Finds a good one through there.
Of course, there'll be a few players retained, and most teams would want to retain their core going ahead into the next season. Shafiq on the short set. Shanti John managed to pick it up. What just happened there? A deflection. Season inflection in the points of the end of our defenders, because somehow from trailing 5-1, they're now leading 8-7 during the Amul Pool technical timeout.
one stat that Amdabad is leading in, it's the blocks. And one player that has stood out already, Shikhar Singh there, down in number five, has crept his way onto that leaderboard despite not starting the first part of this season. Fantastic play by him.
Yeah, players like him and Jishnu have really come into that middle space and made it their own, haven't they?
Meanwhile, the turnaround by the defenders needs to be spoken about. I don't think we ever realize that Burao takes a tumble and he's injured. He's badly injured. No. This is not what the doctor ordered for the defenders. Nanda injured in the previous game and Burao seems to be in heaps of pain.
How many injuries have we seen in the last couple of days? This is the fourth time. Maybe even five. Oof, that's unlucky for Amdabad. They do have Manoj, Mountain Man, on the sideline, certainly ready to come in, but you just hate to see when players have to bow out without having a say in it. Oh!
Just landed on Shaunti John and therefore twisted his ankle. That's unfortunate. That's really, really unfortunate.
Yeah, that's a bad one, I think.
I'm always shocked at how many players don't wear ankle braces. I spent my entire career as a middle. Oh, can't watch that again.
Well, Nanda, Andrew James, and Ilya Burao all needing the stretcher the last couple of nights. Straight down the tunnel for Burao. Fingers crossed for him. And just another problem for that man to solve as well. Dragan Mihailovic, no Nanda. But here he is.
You know what that does, Louis? I wonder what it does to the mentality of the team as well, because of course you've lost this man and they did manage to bounce back. They were unfazed because they had a Shaunti John. Right now, this is the pressure is on in this match for the defenders. And then to see one of your main players get injured the way that he did, I wonder what effect it has on the mentality of the team.
Galvanizing, hopefully.
It didn't do well last time. I did pick up Angamutu. He had to have a spectacular match, which he did. But now Calicut, I feel as though they can smell blood in the water at this point. Arupe contactless shot on the outside from Shirag. Tied up at eight.
It's a big time for him to go off as well, isn't it? But I actually think it's a like-for-like replacement. I don't think Burao is so much better than the Mountain Man either. So let's see how he fares.
Shaunti John came up trumps though. Heart and mouth stuff first when Srikant fell awkwardly during that rally. But somehow the defenders maintained their composure.
Yeah, looking at that first contact, I thought the libero was going to be the next to go. But good work by Shaunti John to keep a head about him, keep his wits, and just focus on the ball in front.
Very little game time for Manoj, the man mountain this season. Was instrumental and pivotal to the defender's success last time around along with Dan Moitazedi. Good pick out by Alan Ashik. Not so much by Ukra as Chirag has to just palm it through. Even Angamutu couldn't do much. Ooh, what was that? Peroto towards Chirag. Even Angamutu to Muthusami. Over the scorer's table, this rally is going everywhere but the court. And eventually, when they landed back in Chennai and weren't playing in Sri Lanka or in Kashmir, it worked out.
Yeah, they took a couple of jet planes and then returned to the court. What a rally. Calicut keeping the final say there down the line as Mutu brought that in a little bit. Left a lot of space to target Angamutu.
Srikant not so good on the dig, and that's why trouble in paradise for the defenders. Srikant again, this time much better. The angle man! The defenders have stolen a point. They've absolutely stolen a point here.
Yeah, the last two rallies for me have been wild. Lots of little mistakes, lots of things that didn't add up. And well, in the end, they're in rhythm because of a lack of defensive concentration, I would say, from the Heroes. That's only going there. And unfortunately, Ukra was looking around, and I think he wants to free himself up to set the ball, granted. But there's the odd ball that you have to play defensively as a setter, and I think that was the one.
Yeah, they're really targeting him, aren't they? When Amdabad is out of system, every single ball seems to be going to Ukra's way.
Ashok, meanwhile, ensures that the Calicut Heroes stay right in it. He's smiling.
Yeah, no pressure. No pressure on them. Plenty of reason to stay smiling if you're head coach.
Also, because 2 years in a row, the Heroes have stumbled at the semi-final hurdle. The moment there were no semi-finals, they've leapfrogged above everyone else and launched themselves into a spot of reckoning. Angleman. Nice dig there by Chirag. Mutsutsami with the dump. Alan Ashik reads it. Angleman yet again. Again, Chirag does oh so well. Saving the Heroes time and again. Ukra, Perotto finishes it off. It's a rally of epic consequences.
How many rallies have we seen that have just been awkward, uncomfortable, but Calicut finding a way to get it done? I just don't even know what to pinpoint from this. Some excellent defense, but that sort of roll shot from Daniel really out of character. Max Seneca having to fall backwards, and Perotto, I think I saw him communicate with Ukra as he was stepping backwards, saying, get me this ball right now, I'm feeling good. Catches the blockers on the way down.
There is no doubt that Chirag was the hero for the Calicut Heroes in that instance. Three superb digs by him, and he's at the baseline now. Not so much a hero this time, though.
Commentator's curse, is that what that is? As soon as you hype him up?
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much.
I can't really get a grasp of this match. I'm trying to sort of put into words what exactly is going on down there. And we're all kind of looking at each other here in the booth going, which way is this going? What exactly is going on down there? It's not great volleyball, it's also not awful.
It's entertaining, let's just call it what it is. It's entertaining! And the SBI Super Point, courtesy of Bishnoi Bazooka, goes the Heroes' way.
All right, so finally a stab in one direction. A bit of a lead here now from Calicut off this SBI Super Point, which was called pretty good timing, I think, when it throws backcourt, three attackers in the front. And he's been the go-to man.
Man, isn't he?
Yeah.
I like him. He's hit the line. He's come into the angle. He's proven that in big moments, he can put the ball away. Very good second to Jerome.
Meanwhile, Praveen has come in, the server specialist usually for the Calicut Heroes. Goes cross-body with the left. A sling of the arm, but the sling of the arm by Angamuthu is also effective. The angle man saves the day yet again.
Yeah, Sleekap's really struggling in the pass, and that's putting even more pressure on the angle man. That ball's way off the net, but somehow he's managed to get around it. Fair play to Mutu Sami, actually, for getting that ball into a window that the angle man can get after it.
I'm surprised we didn't see an SBI Super Point called by the coach of Amdabad, because now they're going to have to climb back in. They're going to have a one-point deficit.
Yeah, good point, Key. Even I'm surprised that they didn't, because Ashok Bishnoi will take the Heroes to set point. And they have two occasions to close the set out.
Wow. We didn't know Calicut had two great opposites in their side, did we? Rupe contact with short. Seneca goes for the soft one, the controlled one. And in the end, it puts Calicut in system. Ashok puts away.
It is Ashok now at the baseline. It is Ashok now off the baseline. One set point save. Good to see the service error.
Well, he was the hero in the last match. Perhaps putting that pressure on himself now to do the same thing.
Well, that's a fair point. That's a fair point. Expectations only get much more when you perform so well as he did. And he's just telling, Shailen Ramdu is just telling Ashok Bishnoi, in such an instance, you can just hit in a floater, can't you? Indian Oil MVP leaderboard sees Jerome Vineet ahead of Santosh, who had the opportunity to overtake him in the previous match but could not. Amit Gulia, his tournament has come to an end. Nandagopal Subramaniam, well, his team is still alive, but unfortunately his tournament has been cut short due to injury. And Aponza has made his way into the top five, the Dancing Devil. But I don't think Jerome Vineet will get an opportunity to increase the lead right now because we're not getting to see him much.
Yeah, and that's okay, because in Ashok they have another great opposite. That's what we're learning. Wow, like he would get into a host of other sides, I think, in this league if he's playing this aggressively with a serve like he has as well.
He hasn't had a single look in all season long. Set point now for Calicut again.
Yeah, Perotto with a reception error, but Perotto, when he took the swipe, got a sliver of the blockers. And the first finalist of this season have piled on the pressure on the defending champions. Can they mount a comeback? That remains to be seen.
Big swing from Perotto up against three blockers. Gives it the fist pump because he knows his team is looking so smooth right now. They've had to grit it out for a couple of rallies, but they now have a 2-0 lead over the defending champions. We'll take a short break. We'll be back to see how this unfolds.
Let's welcome our super fans right here. Welcome to Season 3 of Rupay Prime Volleyball League, powered by A23. It's time for the Indian Terrain Volley Trivia. So let's meet our super fans. Unga per enna? Endha team support pandreengendradhu theriyudhu? Yaar unga favorite ana player?
Uku.
Okay. And unga per enna? Who is your favorite player?
My name is Ramdas. My favorite player is Ukkura Pandian.
Ukkura Pandian. Okay, I'm going to ask you a few questions, very simple questions. Yaar first answer pandreengalo avangalukku da Indian Terrain oda gift voucher. Okay, come closer. Mic central la veppen. Yaar first solringalo avangalukku da gift voucher. Ready, let's go. Which Ahmedabad defender player is among the top 3 diggers in the league as of now? Endha or player top 3 digger ah irukkaru?
Angamuthu
illa. And avurude position vandu fourth position la irukkaru. And avurude jersey number 27, yara solla mudiyuma? Okay, our first pair, Max. Okay, it's Max Seneca abindradhan pere. And let's move on to the next question. Which Calicut Heroes player featured in Ahmedabad Defenders last season? Endha or player last season la Calicut Heroes la ippa irukra player Ahmedabad ka?
Daniel.
Daniel is the right answer. Ladies and gentlemen, we have got the winner for Indian Terrain. And it's Volley Trivia la jeichirukirathu Calicut Heroes supporter. Congratulations. Thank you so much, Parasit Panathike. And ladies and gentlemen, we have saw a winner right here. We also request all of you to put your stories, posts on social media using the hashtag called #PVL and tag Prime Volley. You stand a chance to be the winner today and win the official merchandise of Rupay Prime Volleyball League. Please get ready and be the Asli supporter of the day. Let's go for the set number 3 of the match.
Well, the big news here is that the Calicut Heroes take a 2-0 lead against an Ahmedabad Defenders side that desperately need to win this to go through to the elimination match in 2 days' time. There are the stats. The successful spikes, way better from Calicut. Ashok, one of the main men, and the unforced error is higher though.
Meanwhile, the best seat in the house is actually Blobby, the Nippon Paint mascot. Louis, you'd love if he was sitting right here next to us though, wouldn't you?
You call him the best seat in the house. Have you tried sitting on him? Is that what you were saying?
On Nando or on Blobby?
On Blobby.
I haven't sat on either of them.
Blobby would be comfortable because he's full of air. He's like a little beanbag. Meanwhile, The angle man gets the first point.
Well, it's do or die now for Abdaban. They have to step their game up. And it's not been, I wouldn't say it's been a super smooth sailing for Calicut. However, Abdaban just not putting up enough of a fight.
Yeah, they need to win 3-2, and they also need to make 10 points back to qualify now. So that's the difference, is that they need to not only win 3-2, but they need to accumulate 10 more points over Calicut to get through and pass Bengaluru on points difference, because the set difference would be the same.
Oh, fascinating mathematical genius going on in your head over there, Louis.
No, he's right. He's absolutely right, because...
Don't tell him that.
sometimes, Louis embraces his inner Einstein, and I'm all for it. Seneca. Shanti John. No. First point for Heroes, courtesy of Shanti John error. It's a little scrappy, isn't it?
It's funky. It's really funky down there.
It's been a strange evening. Both games have been what you'd expect from a final game in the Super Fives, with a lot on the line. Nobody's really come out and said, I'm going to go for this, apart from Ashwell. But
oh, yeah.
It's very strange. Chirac had a great game. I think the Calicut Heroes have done exceptionally well, considering the situation that they're in. And I think that the Abdaban defenders have done exceptionally poorly in the situation that they're in, because if you're not going to go full send now, boys, and turn it on, it won't happen for you.
Meanwhile, a Kred super block one-on-one. Daniel shutting down Shikhar. I feel like that had a little extra sauce on it going up against a player that's been brought into his position from last season.
There are five receivers. No, Muthusami is turning and running away. But doesn't matter. It's been given the defender's way, courtesy and overreach. Are they going to ask for a review?
Yeah, that might be worth the... Daniel says, no, put the paddle down. We've already gone through this once this year, and I was sure that I was in the wrong, and I wasn't, so... Or sure, he was in the right and he wasn't. Let's see if it happens again. But I think that that was fair enough, because I think that was an overpass. Let's see.
Oh.
Yeah, that's fine in my eyes.
It they wasn't even Daniel, that. It was Perotto.
It was Perotto.
And I think you're exactly right. That ball was well and truly going over the net. If anything, Mutu was in the wrong.
Yeah, they should have reviewed. Anyway, hindsight is always 20-20. Seneca with a massive dig, Muthusami with the set towards the angle man. It ricochets off Perotto's hands and it goes into the sea. A sea that sees the end of our defenders get a 2-point lead.
Wow, it's funny, isn't it? You get a little bit of momentum before that last decision and all of a sudden the angle man has to spring in his step. Great read from Seneca, to be honest. Sweeping up the defense wide at position six.
One thing we haven't seen, I don't think at all, is a set from Mutu to Seneca. Their connection was way off in the last match, and I don't know that we've even seen them try today.
Meanwhile, this is the first time we've seen Praveen be included in open play, and he was the one with the reception.
Yeah, typically he comes in just as a serving substitute. That one, though, a Rupe contactless shot. Again, Daniel finding the end line. What I love about Daniel's swings are they don't go straight down. He's not looking for just that big bang shot. If he sees something open deep, that's always a good shot.
And my theory is off kilter, because Aman Kumar has come in, but Jerome hasn't. So the setter has changed. Okra has been given a reprieve. Muthusami, meanwhile, sets the angle man expertly. He is the go-to man for a reason.
Yeah, and Aman's done okay since he's come on this time. I'm intrigued to know what will happen without Ukra and Jerome on the court for this team, though. One-on-one, angle man against Perotto. You put your house on the angle man. Sorry, no one. Look how delighted he is with himself. Let's go, angle man.
The only first teamer that you can see right now, there are two of them. One of them is Vikas Mann, the other is Perotto, as Ashok Bishnoi fires one through.
What an interesting Heroes lineup we have. and you almost don't even recognize them. So if they can pull out the win here in 3 sets to 0, that just shows you how deep the bench is.
Yep, and also how Ahmedabad haven't quite rocked up.
And also goes to show that we were talking about Delhi Toofan squad depth, but then the Heroes have always had this in their kitty. They just never showed this card. Wait a minute, Peroto is asking for a review. What is he asking for a review? He says...
ball came off his foot.
They'll get a replay if this is found to have significant evidence behind it.
Well, the problem here that I'm seeing for Peroto is it has to come off clean. He might have felt it on his foot, but what are the odds that it hit his foot and also the floor?
I think it might be obviously up in his hands, but you guys. I think he has a case. I think, and the one thing that's in his favor is the referee blowed it so early that the point wasn't over.
Yeah.
So that means he has a case to for a leg if it did hit his. But there you go, there's a man you wouldn't mess with, especially on an evening like tonight.
I told you a few days ago, he reminds me of Gandalf. As Dragan Mihailovic. Just his poise and his charisma on the sidelines.
Lovely guy, though. Having had the chance with Key to chat to him a lot of times. Very knowledgeable about his volleyball.
Absolutely.
Very passionate about his volleyball.
Holds his team to a very high standard as well.
Yeah, that's up.
There's the pop.
Yup.
Boop. Straight up into the net. Another contact.
Would they get a shoe in then to replay the point?
I think they should. Absolutely. If what we're seeing, if the referees are seeing the same thing we're seeing from that angle.
So Peroto did channel Pelé for a minute there.
It's in the blood. The Brazilians just absolutely cannot resist playing a little bit of footy.
Meanwhile, Vikas Mann is out as well. And now Shafiq has come in. So Peroto is the only first teamer on court for the Heroes.
Wild.
Shrikant. Mastermind Muttasami towards Shanti. John Allen Ashik does enough. Peroto goes and meets and greets the Calicut Heroes fans. Ashok Bishnoi just tips it away. The angle man trying in Ashok Bishnoi. Shafiq has to set towards Bishnoi. That's off target. The defenders maintain their lead.
Yeah, he just gets caught underneath the ball there. And I think the longer the ball has to travel, the more patient you have to be. And you'll be able to see he's already running in there. And he's caught underneath it. And when you're underneath the ball, your arm can't come through.
Yeah, it was out of system. It wasn't set in rhythm. So maybe needing to wait to look and watch it a little bit more.
Peroto climbs. Peroto spikes. Thwarted. Angle man. It's crashed into him. Like a ton of bricks.
Big block. The heart rate of the Lees creeping up as we get closer and closer here in the third. I like the look of that block. Peroto just low and tight. Oh, it's actually through the middle. Shafiq getting one up on the angle man. Yeah, he loves it.
Every point means so much to those two.
Why is he not watching it with his team?
He probably gave him a day off. Said, look, boys, have a rest, do what you need. Put your mind off of volleyball if that's the case.
You can't control this, right? So if you don't want to watch it, you can go and do whatever you need to. Sargan's probably out and about in town. Kieran's probably out for dinner.
I'm pretty sure many of them are glued to the television screen.
They are all glued to this. And hello.
Hello, boys.
Shanti John. Aman, back set towards Ashok Bishnoi. He's missed two in a row like that now.
And that's the difference, right? We talk about him filling the shoes of Jerome. Can he do it 9 times out of 10 or just a few? Mokul technical timeout is here. We'll talk more about that on the other side of this break. Welcome back. It is all happening here. Here is a look at the points table here in the Super Fives of the Rupay Prime Volleyball League. Well, Mumbai unfortunately already out of the mix. Calicut, however, have secured their spot as number one. Ahmedabad are trying to get into that top three because number two and number three will battle it out to play in the final. It's an eliminator match.
Fairly simple. You can win two sets by a differential of two, or one by three, and then they need to win one set by about five or six, which is nigh impossible. Praveen with a crack. And I bet the ball doesn't look the same again.
My word. What a play that is for Praveen. We haven't seen much of an A23 Super Spike. His natural place to hit cross body. But that is an unbelievable swing to the line.
Shafiq. Seneca. Oh, Peroto does so well. So does Shafiq. Look at him run. Bishnoi. Shanti John. Muttu towards the angle man. Peroto yet again. Bishnoi with the bazooka. It's fired. And it hurts the defenders.
Every point matters. That's the key thing. Whether they win a set or not. Every point for the Calicut Heroes affects this one.
Super scrappy in the defense there. Excellent pickup by Peroto. 2-3 times in a row to allow his team to go again. And the trouble, I think, for the defenders right now is all that homework they might have done before leading up to this match against every player on court. None of them are there, so they got to make it up as they go now.
Peroto, as Manoj missed the swipe. Ah! A no-look spike by Daniel Moitazedi. Get the flare on! Wasn't effective enough, though. Picked out, and then the angle man, yet again, doing what the angle man does best.
Yeah, good thing again from Peroto. That's creative, but he still had another touch, I think. He could have set that one for Tazenti, and in turn, they've lost one. Oh, Corral?
Yeah. He doesn't want to miss the game, though, because he knows what's at stake. Now, that's good team spirit, isn't it? Obviously, he's in a world of pain. He's sitting on the sidelines. Our cameraman there, Dilip, capturing him well. Didn't capture the ball well, though, did Harsh Chaudhary, who'd come in as a serving specialist. An interesting point you made there earlier, Key, about the fact that all these players are out of syllabus, as we take a look at Burau yet again, resting his ankle. The other thing that comes to my mind is the fact that because they're not the first teamers, they want to create an impression. And therefore, they'll be playing much better, or they would have more intent in this match. SBI Super Point, called by the defenders. At this moment, Srikant, Shikhar, Praveen, that'll be a four touch. Yep, the SBI Super Point goes the end of our defender's way.
Yeah, again, the pass wasn't quite there, the set wasn't quite there, but they found a way to find the gap. And I think that's a sign of a back three here that haven't played together much. I have no idea where Aman, I think it is going there. That's not his zone.
Bit of confusion. Peroto was all over that in a really simple position to take it. Just that confusion, exactly like you said, Louis. They just don't know each other well enough in a game situation. Super Point now, an SBI Super Point called by Calicut.
Praveen, Aman. Praveen with his lefty swipe. Srikant. Shanti John sends it back. Praveen against Seneca. Sensational by Seneca. Back-to-back SBI Super Points go the defender's way, and you've got the 5 points you desired.
5 points close now, that's huge. 5 from 10, and the dig from Mutu Sami is probably the difference this one here. That dig has kept their dreams alive here in the Rupay Prime Volleyball League. Praveen getting a lot of the ball. I wouldn't have gone there again, I'd have flipped it to the pin. But the defenders against the second string of the Heroes are finding a way back.
This is nail-biting stuff. No matter who you're rooting for, what outcome you're looking for, Kishore Kumar, however, has not broken a sweat.
He doesn't need to. He doesn't need to. He knows. His entire team knows that they've already got the final in the bag. All these players have a chance to impress, and that's what matters.
Do we think that Calicut know the math that has been done about the 10-point differential, or do you think they're just really just trying to give some game time?
I think they just want to win, but they want to give the opportunity to those players that haven't played or haven't had a telling contribution so far to make an impression. Keep in mind, as Ashok Bishnoi takes yet another crack, it's set point defenders, a 6-point lead.
Plus, if you are Calicut, you're going to have seen what's happened to Nanda, you're going to have seen what's happened to Barao, and you're going to turn around and say, okay, Ukra, we've got to protect you. And Jerome, we've got to protect you.
Good point. Very fair point.
I said that at the top of the program. Like, it's as much about winning, but it's about as much about protecting them. And also, if you play them tonight and they don't turn up and they play poorly, then also the knock-on effect of that is the knock of confidence before the final. There's a double-edged sword, this situation, for them. If they come out and perform, it's great. But if you don't, you're going to suffer for it. At least they have the excuse of not having Jerome and Ukra at their first six on if they do lose.
Praveen.
Oh!
That's an Indian Oil super serve! By the slinger! The man with the mullet!
Look, here you go.
I just don't know how many more twists and turns this match has left in it. An Indian Oil super serve right down the middle. Two players watching it fall, and it might cost them.
Oh, the difference is now 3, and the difference needs to be 10 at the end of the game if they win 3-0. That's a huge play.
That they can still make it a difference of 4 if they win the set point. There they won it. An Indian Oil super serve, and then a service error after that. The defenders need to make up a deficit of 10. They made up a deficit of 4 so far, but they need to win the next two sets as well. This is as tight as it can get. The end of our defenders winning this set, getting some reprieve. 15-11 in their corner.
The reigning champs are still alive. 18 successful spikes, more blocks. Look at the unforced errors from the heroes playing their second six. But the big news here is that they've gained 4 points on the Bengaluru Torpedoes. If they do win this 3-2, they have to win by a difference of 10.
And they've already got 4, so now they just need to win each of these 2 sets by 3. Nanda watching on. Bet his heart rate's racing.
They should have put a heart rate monitor on him as well.
Let's just get everyone in the stadium with a heart rate monitor on and just pick and choose who we want to talk to. That wouldn't be too expensive, would it? We can get a sponsor for that.
I feel bad for the batteries, though. Ukras come back in as the setter, and he's already done better. Ashok with the point.
Yeah, I think that's the difference for them. I think Ukras sets, they see this through. It just depends how much jiggery pokery Kishore Kumar wants to play. And Charlene Rambu.
They love the jiggery pokery. They want to keep us on the edge of our seats as long as possible.
The mullet man, this time towards Shanti. John shot set. Ah! Perotto, please be careful. Please be careful. As the tournament has gone on, of course, there's fatigue that's setting in, and sure-footedness is not the order of the day today anyway.
That was awkward looking.
Just as Perotto slipped, the word slipped as well.
I wasn't sure what to say there.
What do you have to say for that? Ashok Bishnoi getting the second point in a row for the Heroes.
Getting set every ball. I mean, surely the defenders have to come up with a bit of a plan and a ploy here. One-on-one. Chikar goes with Montezetti. One-on-one into the angle. Look at those two brothers.
Meanwhile, Perotto has now been given some respite. It's Ashwin Raj that has come in. Montezetti took a leap of faith, but faith didn't go along with him.
Yeah, he goes back and forth. I think he's of two minds. Sometimes he's just standing, floating, being really risk averse. And then sometimes he just really wants that big, big moment to go his way.
Praveen towards Ukras. Ashwin Raj, has he gotten a touch? He has. That's the first point for Ashwin Raj in this entire match. Usually a substitute for Perotto.
Oh, the flare from Ukra. A thing of beauty. Run the outside in the middle and let him swing away.
Where did that come from, Louis?
I just love watching that play.
Has he won you over yet?
No. but like, I enjoy him and the way that he thinks about the game, that's for sure.
Yeah, Louis and I discuss a lot, probably more than is even
more
healthy, about Ukra and his setting, because I'm a huge fan of his trickiness, his trickery, his fast feet, his
jiggery pokery.
Jiggery pokery. He reminds me of...
Exactly.
He reminds me of Dzeko, an Argentinian center who's very similar build, very similar style, just loves a little bit of fun in his setting as well.
Interestingly enough, I felt Sajjad Hussain Malik was tempted to dig that ball. Oh, crap! Your hands were too soft, along with Shafiq. An easy point for the defenders when they probably shouldn't have lost it.
Well, he also compares me to Daniel Craig.
You're dreaming, Louis. You're absolutely dreaming.
I am.
In another alternate parallel universe where humans didn't exist, you would look like Daniel Craig. Shikhar, Praveen, Ashwin Raj. That's boombastic.
Come on, Louis. Come on. Look at that. He's moved forward into zone 4. He's got 2 quick balls in front of him. Watch this. It's not the best pass. Ukra, instead of feeding the middle when there's a big block in front of him, finds that quick ball to the outside.
Just plays a little pop ball over the top. Yeah, it's great. Like, it's great. For me, it just, at international level, I don't think it would work as naturally as playing a bit more authentically. And yeah, but it's highly entertaining and I enjoy watching it. So I definitely give him that. And I also think he's one of the best setters in this league, and what he brings to it is superb.
I think you're also maybe a bit old school, and you want your setters always to square up, always to get their feet there. But I think the speed of this international game going forward, Dili knows better than anyone, is that if you can be a little more loose with it, you might have success.
Ashwin Raj, meanwhile, after that good serve, while Louis and he had gone off on a tangent, Ashwin Raj with a big serve and then with a service error. It is 5-5. I just had to bring it back to the conversation on court.
Yeah. We're there. We're right there with you. Oh,
is that why you call him Manoj the Man Mountain? That's exactly why you call him Manoj the Man Mountain.
And that's a point for Louis.
That's a pass. Yeah, again, that's a real good commitment. Everyone sees it's going that way. And again, Ucra says, my bad. He always tries to work the middle in that situation, so it's interesting to see how and when it works. And again, they're under the cosh here. And my problem is, when he tries to set that ball, it looks flat, but the hitter doesn't have angles to choose from. Can never come over the left shoulder, can never come in sharp. So if the middle commits, the chances are the middle's getting the block. But this is dangerous now.
Angamutu comes at it from the service line again. Better set through the middle that time. Nothing Manoj could do to get in the way.
For a moment, it looked like time stood still, and Daniel Moitazedi is making it 7 on court for a minute. 102 for Sajjad Hussain Malik. That's about to creep up now as he runs across and picks up the paddle. It's an SBI super point.
No, it's not.
No, it's not? Gandalf says no.
And he did say no, didn't he?
Well, it's the fellowship for the defenders, right? And everyone has to play their part. Ashwin Raj. Bishnoi, this time, the Man Mountain can't direct the block.
Every point means so much to the defenders and the Torpedoes. And it's a little two-point swing off the hands. Again, a good high rip. He's a big unit, Ashwin. And we haven't seen him tear away with too many cross-court angles. But at times it doesn't matter because he's so high.
Now they've called for it because it's yet again a Shafiq serve. 2 points on the line. Srikant, Muthusami, Angleman, of course it's him. Of course it's him. It is always him. It had to be him. The Angleman files the defenders into the lead, courtesy the SBI Super Point, and during the Amul Cool technical timeout, they have the two-point differential they desire.
Here's another look at that SBI super point from earlier. The Angleman getting a rip as easy as you like. He just makes it look so, so simple when he gets that high contact over the block.
A penny for that man's thoughts.
I'd pay more than a penny.
Imagine it's not about dinner. Imagine it's not about next week. It's, I imagine that he's very present in what he's thinking and how he's going about his business.
Meanwhile, Ashok Bishnoi had clipped the hands, which is Ashanti John had to keep it in play. The point goes the hero's way as Manoj crashes into the net.
Ukra again trying to find the middle in that awkward spot. This time it pays off easier for Daniel. I think because they're not so close to the net, because Manoj doesn't just have his hands taken away all the daylight, Daniel still has some angles to work with.
Yeah, I would have liked to see Manoj really dive into the cross court there and seen if Daniel could turn it anyway back over his left side, but agreed.
Ashwin Raj does enough. Angamuthu with the dig. Angamuthu yet again. This time it's Ukra, so it goes to Daniel. Danny, the Prince of Persia. What did he do?
He's just a jump serving, hand setting machine today. And he's not overly pleased about this one. But here comes the SBI super point. My word. If you're a defender or a torpedo, surely this is too much.
This is exactly what you would want. Manoj with the serve. Ashwin Raj, good reception. Ukra balloons it towards Ashok Bishnoi. Did he get the touch? No, he didn't. He didn't. 4-point lead. The SBI super point towards the defenders. What's going on?
I haven't seen a ball from Ukra set that high the entire league. Incredibly high set. And Ashwin's in too early because that's not the rhythm they play off. But yeah, Manoj is fast, they're in system. I mean, the heroes relax in the timeout. Wild play this.
We keep our eyes on this number as well, as it's now 8-12. And I'm sure Dili is doing the math as well. He's saying, what's going on here? Why is Calicut not able to put this match away? But this is not the Calicut we've seen all year.
The reason why he's bothered now is because they already got a 4-point difference. Now they've got 4 points more. That makes it 8. 2 more points towards Ahmedabad. So if should Ahmedabad defenders win this, say 15-11 now, if this is the status, then they just need 2 points. So they just need to win the next set by the bare minimum and they're through.
Oof.
Make that a 5-point differential. The heroes are giving it away. That's 9 points now that's been made up. It's about 1 point now.
They certainly are giving it away. It does seem like they're just handing point after point to Ahmedabad, not having to work for any of this.
Yeah, I can't really add much to the fact that they're not doing anything that's really worth much here. For defenders are having it incredibly easy at the moment. Incredibly easy. Daniel Mirtazani is trying to take the pass. All of a sudden, it's comfortable. We're going to a fifth and final set. And there's so much on the line for everybody else but Calicut.
You've got the 10-point differential now. It's done. Calicut ahead as we speak, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously, they need to win the next set. Again, a reception error. And Seneca just tips it through. Soft hands. And now the defenders know all they need to do is win the next set. And the torpedoes will tumble out. Drama of the highest order.
Well, here we go. We knew it was going to come down to 5 sets. Surely, would you have it any other way? It's 2-2. We'll be back after a short break for the drama to continue to unfold.
You guys, I said, and Marika, man, rainbow, and diamond.
when it's been a brilliant Super Fives. The final game goes to the final set, one that the defenders have to win. 23 successful spikes to 32, but 21 unforced errors and 9 blocks is what swayed this back in the direction of the underback defenders, who have been unlucky to lose 2 3-2s, but all of their matches in the Super Fives now going the distance. We just had a quick look at David Lee. I'm sure his heart rate is up there.
It is up there because the differential that they needed in terms of points has been made up. They're ahead in terms of points. And that's also prompted a change by the Heroes. Second time around, Moitezedi has tried this no-look hit. And second time around, it's been blocked. They read the script to the defenders even before Moitezedi's written it.
Well, I don't mind that swing by Daniel. He's doing what he can there. What bothers me is the players around him seeing it come back and not too fast.
Yeah,
relatively slow and defendable.
And Ikra just blames Daniel straight away and he says, what are you doing? And Ikra's not covering. So it's like, I think everybody's a little bit out there, like a little bit to blame, to be fair. This is going one way now. I'm sorry to say it. I just don't see the Heroes getting any headway here.
What they have done though is get Chirag on court, and Chirag is the one who put in that spike and they've gone for a review. Like to see whether it's for a touch out or for a net touch.
Is this a challenge that they believe in, or is it just to help stop the momentum sieve?
Well, it's been prompted by the Prince of Persia, Dan Moitezedi.
And we know his record with challenges.
It's for a touch out.
It'll be that right hand just...
I think it's past. Nope. It's past it. Daniel seems a little flummoxed. Maybe he wanted them to take a net touch review.
Oh, that's potential. Let's have a look at that net then. Do you see any wiggles?
Well, you can't review it anymore though, because you have to give the one, you tick mark the one thing that you want to be reviewed. In this instance, it's for the touch. I doubt you'd get to know from that angle.
Yeah, I think we've decided the touch is not there, but I'd like to see if that net touch, if there's any validity to that either. No, I don't think so.
Right, is this one of those situations where there's inconclusive evidence and then therefore the review is retained? Because this could be pivotal. This could be pivotal.
They still have 2 reviews left. So if this doesn't go their way, they still have 1 left.
I'm thinking more in terms of just the potential swing. In terms of if this is given the Calicut Heroes way, at least they get to even Stevens. Should they lose this point, the defenders have the early lead to close out the match and thereby booking a place in the eliminator. So there's much more hanging on this review than just the fact that they might lose a review.
Yeah, true, true, true.
So they do lose the review. What could have been 3-1 towards Heroes is now 2-2.
The points difference doesn't really matter anymore, as you said previously, Atish. So it's right down to the wire. And it's first point on the board.
What's worrying me for Calicut is they're starting to come apart at the seams in terms of people, like you mentioned, pointing fingers, asking questions of their own teammates rather than sticking together.
Yeah.
As things are getting a little shaky down there, they have to remember, hey, we're in the finals. How we play today is a reflection of how we'll play over the next days.
And that's what I meant about going through early is sometimes a little bit of a double-edged sword if those things creep into a game that you don't really need to win. And they can certainly rot some things within the camp. And I still don't think that this is going to go down very well, because it's a very edgy, complacent, vulnerable performance from the Heroes. Daniel Moitezedi is trying his heart out though, I've got to give him that.
Yeah, he seems one of those who's still keen on giving it his all on court. Perotto's come back. 14 attack points for Rangamuthu, playing that rescue act yet again, the angle man. Chirag to Ukra to Ashok Bishnoi, who's done a fine job in place of Jerome, but of course Jerome is cut off for different gravy, isn't he? What is going on? The heroes are saving the day for the defenders.
Yeah, not all heroes wear capes. Some of them wear maroon.
Dealey just shaking his head, incredibly unimpressed.
All right, so Jerome Vinith is the only starter that's not on court anymore. He's not been there since the first few points of the first set. Perotto comes in. Perotto takes a hit. Perotto misses. They're claiming a touch out. Second review within a few points. Shikhar looks disparagingly, hoping perhaps that they don't take the review. Time's up. Time's up.
Why did they wait so long?
They had no interest, I don't think. It's the easiest thing, right? The bench looked at them and then they kept the paddle down, so...
That's better. You need to do a few more of that, but it's already a three-point differential and Daniel's trying to egg his fans on. Nothing she can't do there.
Daniel at least brings his full heart, whether he's right, whether he's wrong, whether he's challenging, whether he's pulling his shirt off after the game. You cannot fault him for wearing his heart on his sleeve.
And he's just being replaced, actually, for the service of Praveen.
Save the Indian Oil Super Serve. We haven't seen much effect from the mullet man.
Well, that tells you everything you need to know about how the Torpedoes are feeling right now.
Shikhar. Well, at least they made it exciting as the defenders. Ukra. This time it didn't work.
I don't know even if the defenders have played well, though.
I don't think they have.
So, I think they've had a very edgy game where Callum could have just rolled over for them. And I don't know if we'll see a performance like this from Calicut for the rest of the season when the going gets tough in that final.
Now remember, if Ahmedabad do actually complete the turnaround, they become only the fourth team to go from two sets down to 3-2 winners as the angle man. Of course he's at the forefront. He's always at the forefront.
Yeah, the last two games with no Nanda and now no Barao. He's getting the job done wonderfully, isn't he? A one-on-one. And I mean, in this situation, I don't think I would ever give the one-on-one to Angamutu on that side with the rotation the way that it is.
Ukra. Perotto! He turned Angamutu into a pastry for himself at that point.
Big swing from Perotto. Excellent hold, the middle staying in the middle, gets the field goal on Angamutu's legs. Is it too little too late? Can we see a comeback here from Calicut, spurred on by this man here?
Seneca, mastermind Muthusamy, the man mountain, climbs to the peak and sets his affairs in order. A four-point lead. The defenders are on course of completing the most epic comeback. It's time for an Amul Cool technical timeout.
Well, the Amalcour Emerging Player nominees, you've got to be under 25 and not have represented India internationally. Anand running very hot here. Nanda as well should be playing tonight, but unfortunately due to that ACL injury, he's not experiencing this success. But there he is, Nanda. It's great to have you with us.
Yeah, and he's getting married in April. That's his fiance with him. There's good news for him at least in this difficult time. And there's good news for Chirag Yadav as he registers yet another point.
Well, let's do the math here. We've pretty much said that we think this is done and dusted for Omdurman. However, big swing there. Maybe one more point in the pocket of the defenders, or excuse me, of the heroes, and then an SBI super point goes their way. I don't think this match is done.
No, it's definitely not done.
This is an interesting substitution. Shafiq goes out, Ashwin Raj comes in. And then Ashwin Raj goes back out, and Shafiq will take his place. So now you can't use Ashwin Raj again.
David Lee looks like he's about ready to leave the building. I think he's done watching. I think he's seen as much as he needs to see.
Yeah, I would say this is the last chance. They pick on Manoj every time, which is very good tactic. Manoj having that soft to serve.
Mukesh Okra. Point is ready. 2 points. Courtesy the SBI Super Point, courtesy the Prince of Persia, the Calicut Heroes way.
Where's the celebration? I mean, that's a big moment for Calicut. Big swing from Daniel. Turn around. Is there even a high five from anyone? Is anyone even looking at each other in the eye?
Yeah, just Daniel and Perotto giving it some stacks, but that's about it.
They're going through the motions. Ah, Mukesh. But ah, Shikhar. Is it an overreach? That's what the heroes are appealing for. Take the review. Stop. Instead of debating, why not take the review?
They're just running the clock out, I think. Daniel cannot believe it. That was
this is
a reach over.
Yeah, that is a handover all day long.
Why didn't they take the review then?
I just think Calicut, they don't need this win as much as Bengaluru do.
Yeah, they're not doing any favors to Bengaluru Torpedoes. They're just ensuring that Ahmedabad the Bard still have their work cut out a little bit. They still need to close out the game.
Good work on
Angaluru goes up, and Ashwin does a good job of getting through the block.
Chirag Yadav, meanwhile, Indian Oil Super Serve, perhaps that could change things around. Srikant takes a piece of it. Muthusami towards Angamuthu. Perotto, Okra, Ashok. That's it. That's a 1 point difference now. Is this the way? Is this the way to go?
Healthy swing on the right side there. Ashok's been the man of the hour for Calicut. 14 points he has in that Rupay contactless shot, cross court. He's been phenomenal.
Yeah, he has. Great serving. The little match on that from Chirag, who's been another good weapon for this team, but he's going to need another couple because the defenders are still the favourites.
You just had to say that, Louis. The curse of the commentator. The defenders are edging towards the eliminator. Dragan shouting some last-minute instructions towards the angry man. Seneca. Daniel Moitazedi had to receive. The pipe attack comes through. Chirag gets yet another point. Chirag has definitely added a spark in the Calicut Heroes.
He's had a great season, hasn't he? A real great season. There's some tension there for sure. We know Dealey well, and we know that he cares about this league and his team incredibly. That Daniel with his jump serve.
Still a 2-point lead. 3 points away. 3 points away.
Way too much risk. Again, I keep saying the same thing over and over. There's certain points in a match where you have to get your serve in. That was one of them.
Berotto. Okra single hand set towards Ashok Bishnoi. Read oh so well, as if the map was carved out by the defenders themselves. 2 points away.
Big block for the defenders. A one-handed put up, and Manoj just coming in late, throwing those arms over.
Wow, two away from what would be an incredible victory for on the back. They've gone to the wire every single time in this Super Five. They're the marathon men of the Super Fives. How's it going to end for that man? Let's have a look at his heart rate. 1, 3, 4.
Oh my God. Wow.
That's racing faster than than something Max Verstappen would drive.
Yeah, I mean, the pressure's high, isn't it? The heroes are certain of their place in the finals. I wonder why there was no review of the handover. That's my big question.
I wonder why there was no heart monitor on David Lee for this game. Okra. Bishnoi gets a point. Goki.
I was just going to say, I wonder if that was D. Lee booking some flights for a small vacation with his wife after the result of this match.
Yeah, the writing's pretty much on the wall, isn't it?
Well, there's one man that could change it. Could be this man.
Yeah, he changed the game when he came in that fifth set. Oh! Almost did it there with a big serve towards Srikant. Chirag, Mukesh. Perotto plays it safe. Muthusamy sets it up for the angle man, who takes his time. Perotto with the wild swipe. Manoj, the man mountain, couldn't do much about it.
This is crazy. There were so many things in that rally that just, yeah, was falling to chance. And that's a good swing. Perotto knows that all three blockers are chasing in. And have a look at Dili. It's so tense in here.
I mean, it's tense up here in the booth, and we have no stake in it. Dili, his entire season rides on these next couple of points. Oh, it is nail-biting stuff. Heart-wrenching, gut-wrenching.
I think Dilip's been told he just needs to fix his camera on David Lee now.
Fair.
Why ever not? So much on the line.
There's some great dance moves in there. Look at this. Look at this guy on the right.
Ashok Bishnoi. Sop to serve this time. Seneca receives. Angleman! It is match point for the defending champions. It's Christmas, Diwali, Holi, all wrapped up in one go.
What a moment. Stepping up in a big way. Angamutu looking like his former self as he is on the line.
Chirag, this is match point. Not yet, not yet, not yet. Don't celebrate yet. Don't celebrate yet. One match point saved.
Yeah, who's up the service line? Perotto, that's a good task. I would chuck him the ball in this situation as well. Although nobody has a choice, but he's been a great server. Comes in clutch when needed.
Muthusamy. Angleman. The end of our defenders may have had their head bloody, but they were unbowed. They were undaunted. They were up for the task. They have made the most epic comeback. A comeback of proportions that see the Bengaluru Torpedoes go out. And the Ahmedabad defenders are in the fray for the final now. They've qualified for the eliminator. Wow!
How do you like that? We thought this was done and dusted. Two sets up were Calicut. They were 1 foot in the door. They will still be on the top of the table, but they have allowed Ahmedabad a seat at the table with this victory come from behind.
Two big wins in a row for Ahmedabad. 2-3-2 victories after 2-3-2 losses sees them into the eliminator. Angamutu's been brilliant in the absence of Manda. And look at Jerome Beneath down there cheering the fact that they go straight through to the final. So Calicut is celebrating as well, although I guess it must feel bitter, somewhat sweet.
Well, they rested Jerome after that second set. He did not see the court, but one man that did, Angamutu, the go-to guy for Ahmedabad, over and over, was back on top form. That final swing to seal the deal between the blockers. He was fantastic tonight, as he has been all season long. 17 points for Angamutu. Breaking hearts on and off the court. That man breaking no hearts, though.
Ah, the man mountain and the man molehill. Next to each other. Look at that lovely photo. And after the game against Delhi, Santosh, former teammate of Manoj, was the first to run over and see the little one with the mountain man, the man mountain, however you want to call him. Jerome Beneath knows that they've done their job as well. Calicut, they go through. Ahmedabad defenders go through. 3-2 win. Time for a quick break. Well, the final game of the Super Fives was a classic, with the reigning champions, the Ahmedabad defenders, needing a victory to make sure they took over Bengaluru Torpedoes and qualify for the eliminator. Calicut already knew they'd won this Super Fives League and they were going straight into the final in 4 days' time. But it was a classic game that went the whole nine yards. It was Calicut that started the better of the two. They rested Jerome Beneath after the first set, happy with his contribution, and it was Underbad under all the pressure early on. As the game materialized, the defenders knew their backs were against the wall and they had to try and win 3-0 or 3-1 to make sure they had their spot in the eliminator. If they won 3-2, it went down to points of difference, in which case they had to be better than the Heroes this evening by 10 points. It was nail-biting the whole way through. And it was the Heroes, although they won the first two sets, were pulled back by a brave Underbad side. The Onshikar, who's been such a revelation since coming into this team at the expense of Manoj. Remember, Manoj coming in this evening due to an injury to Ilya Barao. And in the end, a win. Angamutu brilliant again this evening. Curtains for the Torpedoes. And it's Underbad that go through to the eliminator.
Well, there's how it was done. Underbad, 11 blocks to 3. Calicut were spiking better. However, the errors, 28 unforced errors. We'll have to double check those stats, but that kind of tells you the story right there. We'll head down courtside. Atish is standing by for the presentation.
What the Ahmedabad defenders have done is nothing short of an epic fantasy novel. Think about it, the journey that they've had elements of Lord of the Rings to it, because the journey in itself started off with such difficulty in the Super 5. Back-to-back losses, 3-2, then coming back with a win, 3-2. And now today, when the equation was so against them, they needed to win either by a differential of 10 plus points or win 3-1 or 3-0. Guess what they did? They got a differential of 12. And that means the Bengaluru Torpedoes are out. The Ahmedabad defenders, the defending champions with their mentality, are in the eliminator. They face off against the Delhi Toofans to stake a claim in the final against the Calicut Heroes. And in the presentation party, to my left, representing the Calicut Heroes, is Mrs. Rehmat Safir, the team representative. Representing the Ahmedabad defenders is the co-owner of the team, Mr. Ramsi Chaudhary. And representing Rupee is Mr. Sumant Panda, General Manager, SBI. The first award is the Game Changer of the Match Award. And usually we give this to someone who actually changed the game around, but sometimes you just have to give it for consistency. And he was also consistent. It goes to the mastermind of the team, Muthusami. Captain, as usual, playing his part, playing Angamuthu when he needed to, playing Shanti John. All the players just weave around Muthusami and his game plans. The game changer of the match, the mastermind, Muthusami. Well, up next is the Rupee Player of the Match Award. And ever since the unfortunate injury to Nandagopal Subramaniam, this player has to step up. And step up he did. We fondly call him the Angle Man, and he was to the rescue yet again. The Rupee Player of the Match is Angamuthu from the Ahmedabad Defenders. He will receive the check from Mr. Sumant Panda, General Manager, SBI. He's also awarded the Rupee On-The-Go watch to experience hassle-free payments. And he also gets to sign the match ball for our esteemed guest. Yet another day where Angamuthu racked up the points. Completed 100 attack points today. Oh, Angleman, again to the rescue. What was the message that was sent today before you came onto the court?
Coach has said it's a do or die match, and we play as decided to. It's a do or die. So we decided to go for all out, and actually the players played superbly, and unexpectedly Ilya got injured, and we just kept the momentum not to get down, and not to be morally down. So we just want to continue the momentum and keep playing.
Sometimes it's never easy when you know that the opposition has already booked themselves into the final. There was a certain mentality that they were playing with. How did you keep yourselves focused on what was at task?
we don't want to see others how the players are playing and who and all playing like that. We just want to play our game and to go for the all out. So we just played our game.
Did you have your calculators out prior to the match, knowing what the equations were? Is that an approach that you had to take?
The management people, our team management, had calculated that, and I said players not to go for that. Just play well. It's okay if we lost the match, but try your all out and go for the match like that.
Well, Angleman, you're leading the Avengers of the Ahmedabad Defenders. Congratulations. He wants to say something.
I just want to dedicate this award to my nightmare, Nanda, who got injured, and I hope he'll come back soon and he'll play together for me. Thank you.
Obviously, the Pocket Rocket had an important hand to play usually for the Ahmedabad Defenders. The Angleman dedicating the Rupee Player of the Match award for this one to the Pocket Rocket as the Ahmedabad Defenders have reached the Eliminator.
Well, once again, it was Angamutu, the player of the match. He was fantastic. 19.17 in attack, one of them in block and one in ace. He was all offense, go, go, go. The Energizer Bunny on the right side. Well, they needed him to step up and he did so in a big way. The Mutu-Angamutu connection is back between these two that are headed to the elimination match. This was the last of the Super Fives, and what a performance by Amdamad and that man right there. Well, here's a final look at the points table. Calicut going directly into the final, and Delhi and Amdamad will play the Eliminator. Mumbai were already out before today, but Bengaluru, watching on, will be heartbroken at this result. Well, here you go then, the Eliminator happening on the 19th of March, starting at 6:30 p.m. as the Delhi Tufans taking on the Ahmedabad Defenders. For myself, Key Michael, Louis Lett, Atish Sakral, and Manish Bhatavia, and all of us here at the Rupee Prime Volleyball League, we will leave you with the Nippon Paint colorful moments of the match.